Madam the President, Secretary General, special guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. The video you just saw is meant to honor those who fight crime in the field, in the service of justice every day, no matter where. They are the very reason Interpol was created, and they will always be at the heart of our mission. Each operation, each seizure, each arrest helps change the world into a safer place. Interpol duty is to ensure that this change is lasting and able to impact on the maximum number of people globally. You may not realize it, but communications is also a law enforcement important tool. Communications has a role to play in making sure these police results are meaningful and have continuing influence and value. This is where turn-back crime, Interpol First Communications Campaign, can make a difference. Turn-back crime supported the operations you saw. In turn, these operations helped to promote the campaign. We all know that law enforcement cannot function in isolation. Turn-back crime can create a real link between police, the private sector, and the public at large. The priorities of the campaign are to highlight for civil society the achievement and value of police, to enable law enforcement to better ensure global security, to establish trust of a citizen in their police, to engage the private sector in modern day policing, and finally, to educate people on the role they can play in preventing terrorism and in fighting organized crime. In other words, the campaign can promote a global alliance against crime to turn back crime. Communication is a powerful weapon. Terrorists and organized crime networks learned and know this very well. Strategies of fear, disinformation, and the psychological warfare are used by terrorists and criminals to destabilize communities and governments. The effects of terrorism are amplified through fear. The fear of crime is almost as harmful as crime itself. The terrible crimes are inflicting on the world. Crimes that are screened directly into our homes, bringing us all closer to these horrors. Images are shared through modern technology and social media, spreading fear and panic. Think of the Westgate Center attack in Nairobi. Think of the horrific beheading of charity workers and hostages in front of cameras. Think of the murder of innocent bystanders when the car bombs detonate. It is clear that this complex reality requires innovative tools to fight and prevent crime and terrorism. As Einstein said, our mind is like a parachute. In order to work, it needs to be open. Today, we have a panel of speakers who will bring the turn-back crime concept to life. We will hear from France and from UK about their experiences of conducting awareness campaign to counter violent extremism. In April this year, France set up, for example, a hotline for people to report concerns about friends or family becoming radicalized. By the end of October, the hotline had received around 600 calls from the public, and about 100 of these were to report people leaving the country to go and fight abroad. This reporting mechanism creates a new dialogue between the public and law enforcement around a very sensitive subject like terrorism, violent terrorism. In addition, the UK campaign called Prevent aims to stop people becoming terrorists and supporting terrorism. This campaign works with a wide range of sectors where there are the risks of radicalization. You will recall how at the ministerial conference, the ministers, just Tuesday, reminded us of how counterterrorism and organized crime is a shared responsibility between police, government, private sector, and the public. The Turn Back Crime campaign communicates directly with each of these components. For example, with regard to the general public, we need to speak a language that people can relate to. We need people to want to play a role in tackling the threats. We need them to understand the achievements and value of police. We need to develop a culture of legality. We need our citizens to fear less and to understand more. In the past, Interpol has seen the value of public appeals. Operation Vico was a successful global appeal that identified, located, and arrested a suspected child abuser in less than 48 hours. Public tip-offs sent to Operation Infrared have led to hundreds of arrests of fugitives worldwide. Fugitives wanted for murders, child abuses, drug trafficking, and money laundering. These public appeals are powerful. They demonstrate how the public believe in our mission, and they trust our brand. We now need to take this trust and develop it through Turn Back Crime. Now let's consider the way in which the private sector can get involved. Take the example of a critical infrastructure, which in many countries is largely owned and operated by private company. For instance, maritime and port security. Many countries depend on maritime trade for their economy and businesses. Yet, the threat of piracy undermines these infrastructures, and very often law enforcement are getting involved just at the end of the process, once the incident has happened. Do ship owners and companies know that there are steps that can be taken to prevent such incidents? They can help with the preservation and collection of evidence on their ships. They can provide invaluable testimonials to the court, along with insights to support investigations and analysis. The Turn Back Crime campaign could help in building bridge to raise awareness in fighting maritime piracy. Interpol can also help protect private enterprise, and therefore it means protect economies, social frameworks, workforces, and the communities that such enterprises support. But in order to do so, we need engagement from the private sector itself. What better example than iCheckIt to illustrate this commitment? Yesterday, you voted in favor of iCheckIt resolution. This tells me it's clear to you that cooperation with the private sector is valuable for police work and to help make the world a safer place. You have also seen already how, in a very visible show of support, our partner AirAsia has painted one of their planes with the turn back branding. I think you will agree this plane is set to become one of the stars of the campaign as it travels around the world. Talking of stars, the campaign has attracted many high-profile supporters and ambassadors in different areas. These stars bring a touch of glamour to the campaign, but that's not why we need them. We need them in order to reach their followers, to reach thousands, millions of passionate people who will listen to a message from someone they admire and act on that message. And it's important to bear in mind that all our supports and start have done this for free. The popularity of some of our supports on social media is just outstanding. The Formula One Scuderia Ferrari team has more than 3 million fans on Facebook. The actor Shah Rukh Khan has an amazing 10 million followers on Twitter. And the actor Jackie Chan reaches more than 63 million fans on Facebook. Yes, 63 million. This is the real value they can add. Remember, every tweet share, every phone call, every person can make the world a safer place. Today, we will also hear from the director of a Vatican Gendarmerie on how it is important to develop a dialogue among different components of a society, which goes across borders, across languages, and across cultures. I want to remind you that this campaign was successfully launched in June this year, it means only 5 months ago, on the International Anti-Counterfeit Day around the topic of illicit trade, and has been used widely in support of operations like the one you saw in the video. Today, Interpol is seeking to enlist the support of a law enforcement community, to support your support. We would like you to see the value of using turnback crime in your day-to-day work. This means incorporating campaign messages into your operational activities. In this way, we can add a new dimension to crime fighting. In Nigeria, for example, NCB officers wore turnback crime t-shirt and hats while repatriating a wanted terrorist, a member of Boko Haram, from Sudan to Nigeria. By linking turnback crime to this high-profile event, NCB Nigeria highlighted the fact that law enforcement is a collective and global effort. I urge each of you to help us drive the campaign forward. By being the next to join the campaign, by giving the resolution your full backing. Together, the possibilities are endless. Together we can turn back trafficking, exploitation, terrorism, fear. Together we can turn back crime. Thank you.